Hi everyone, this is Bilal Khan and you are watching Simplified Coding. In the last video, we learned writing unit tests in our Android project. And in this video, we will move a little ahead and we will learn how we can test our room database. As I told you, in this series, I will be building an application and it is a very simple application to save our spends. And the application is called Spend Tracker. Now for this application, I need to save the spend in the local database and I will be using Room to save the database locally. Now I have written all the codes that are required for Room because I am not covering Room in this series. This series is about testing only. Now if you want to learn about Room, then I have given a tutorial link that is in the description, so you can check that out. So basically in this application I need spend to save in my database, and that is why here you can see I have created an entity that we need to create for Room database. So the table name is spends and I have three properties for the spend, and I have one more, that is our primary key, that is ID. So I have ID, date, amount and description for spend, and this is my entity class. After entity I also have this spend DAO. Now we have these two functions that we will test in this video. So the first one is add spend, that will add a new spend to the database, and the next one is get last 20 spends. Now this function will return the last 20 saved spends from the database. I also have created the spend database class, that is our abstract class that extends or inherits the Room database. So as you can see here, we have the database annotation. For entities, I have only one entity here, that is our spend, and then we have the database version. And one more thing I have defined here, that is the type converters. Now here, if you look at the entity class, here I am using date. So you cannot directly save a date type to your Room database. And for this date, I have created this date converter because you need to create the converter if you want to save something to Room database that is not supported. So the date is not supported, and for this, I have created this date converter and I have defined it here in my spends database class. So these all the things are already created. You can get the source code. The link is given in the description of this video. What we will do in this video is we will test our DAO to see whether it is working or not. Now I will open my spend database, and this time also I will right click and I will select generate. Now this time we will select test as we did in the last video because we want to test our database. So click test. Now this is the class name. Everything is okay. Just hit okay. But this time save your test class inside Android test folder, because to build the database context is required. That is an Android specific class. And that is why we are not going to do unit test, but we will do an instrumented unit test because we need Android specific classes. And to run this test, you also need a real device or an emulator. But the database test will run faster because it is not a normal UI test, because to test database, we do not need any fragment or activity to be created. And that is why database test runs a little bit faster than the UI tests. We will learn about UI test in coming videos. So for now, we will create the test class inside this Android test folder. So I'll just hit OK. And this is my test class. Now you need to extend test case to your class like this. And one more thing, you need to annotate your class with run with annotation. And inside this annotation, you will define Android JUnit this time. So we have Android JUnit 4 and then class. And I will also delete this JUnit assert import because we are going to use truth library for the assertions. So we have our class. Now here inside this class, first I will define the database. So I will define private late init where db of type spend database, and I will also define the DAO. So I have private late init where DAO of type spend DAO, like this. Now I will override a function, that is setup. So I will write here override fun setup, like this, and I will annotate this function as before. Now before means this function will be called before each test function. So whenever you will call a test function, this function will be called before, and we can have one more function that is called after. Now this function will be called after the test function. So I will create a function that is closeDB. So what I will do is I will create the database inside the setup function that will be called before the test, and after the test I will close the database. So here I will initialize my database. So what I will do is I will write db equals to room dot in memory database builder. Now this function creates a database in memory. If you will control click to this function, you can see here creates a room database builder for an in-memory database. Information stored in an in-memory database disappears when the process is killed. Now this means we are basically creating a temporary database just for the testing purpose. So we have called this function. Now this function takes two parameters. The first one is context, and the next one is the database class. Now we need to get the context first. And as we are doing an Android JUnit 4 test and it is an instrumentation testing, we can easily get the context. So to get the context, we will write here val context equals to, we will use the class that is called application provider. Now with the help of this class, we will call the function get application context, and yay, we have our context. Now we can pass this context. I need to import it as well. Now we will pass this context, and then we have our database like this. So we have the database. We also need to call the build function to finally build the database. So we have the database. Now with the help of the database, we can get the DAO. So we will call the function get spend DAO, and we will store it inside DAO. Now in the close function, I will write db dot close, like this. Now finally we can write our test functions. Now in this video I will write only one test function. So we need to annotate the test function as test, and then we will write the function. Let's say I want to test fun, write and read spend, because what I want to do is I want to write and spend to the database, and then I will read that spend back and I will confirm whether it is working fine or not. So the first thing that we need is we need the spend itself, and to create a spend we need to create an instance of the spend. So I will write spend equals to spend, and for the parameters we need to pass date, amount and description. So I will create a date instance here like this. I can pass the date here. Let's say amount is 100 and let's say bought something. This is the description. Now I will insert the spend using this DAO. So I will write DAO dot add spend. I will pass the spend. Now here you can see we are getting an error, and this is because this add spend function is a suspending function. That means we need a coroutine scope to call this function, because it is a suspending function and we cannot call it directly. Now if you don't know what is coroutine and how do we use coroutines in our project, then you must check the coroutines tutorial as well. I have given the link to the coroutines tutorial in the description of this video. So for now what I will do is I will create a scope using the run blocking function like this, and inside run blocking we have coroutine scope, and here we can call the functions, suspending functions, very easily. So we have inserted the spend that we have created here. Now if it is working fine, then when we will call the function, that is DAO.getLast20Spends, we should get the spend that we just inserted. So here I will get the spends like this, and finally I will write an assertion. So here I will write assert that, and here I will write spends dot contains spend. I need to import the function, and then I will finally write is true. Now if our code is working fine, that means when we inserted this spend, we should get this spend when we are fetching the last 20 spends. And that is why I am asserting here that this spends should contain this spend, and it is, or it should be true. Now we can easily run the test, and to run the test you can click on this play button. It means run all the test functions inside this class, and you can also individually run your test functions. To do this you can click here. So let's run this test, and you can see I have a real device connected, because to run these tests you need an emulator or a real device. And oops, I did a little mistake here, and that is this override fun setup should be public. So I will write public here, and I will run the test again. And as you can see here, the test passed successfully. That means our database is working absolutely fine. And the same way you can write more test cases. So that is all for this video, friends. I hope you found this video helpful and learned something new. In case you did, then please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to this channel if you're not already a subscriber. And you can share this video with all your friends who are learning Android application development. So thanks for watching, everyone. This is Belal Khan, now signing off.